Okay. Good evening. I had a thought while I was doing things. So thought we'd have a crack at it. Which is so when you do this, I'd like a quicker way of keyboard selecting a spot, basically. So yeah, let's see if we can get that to work. Because I'm trying to support mouse and keyboard controls just in case. It's in the menu. So then. What we should do is something like for target in targets canvas dot print. Zero and target dot pause dot x. Tiles, you got a target dot pause. Something like that. 29. Would be this one. So maybe we'll try 19. If input actions dot options dot any input dot down. How did I do this in the scene? I guess I'm sort of fudging it there. Then current is equal to. Options is equal to this. This should be just pressed now. This should be aware. Like that. Because then we can do if down options dot count is greater than 0, then down options 0. Get the first one that's down. And there. I guess we don't actually know what the key is. Because it doesn't store what the ID of the key is, so there's actually no way to know. That's tricky. What if we do keys? Input group dot new I like that equal key. Yeah. Right. Yep. Targeting menu works with keyboard. Although you can tab and enter through instead, for the directional ones, it might be better to do it numerically. Although you could also have done it with the arrow keys, for the direction keys. But that would require knowing which mode you're in. Not that important. Okay. So. Fire Wizard, that's next. So we have these lovely sprites here that I've been sort of templating from. And this person looks sufficiently ominous, so we'll steal them. And not actually steal, because these are CC by attribution, so. It's fine. Entities, oh, yeah. Entities, we've got this thing, can go here. Something like that. Like that. Like that and like that. Like that. I guess they kind of look like Jawas, which is a bit weird. But. It's probably the only time I've not really wanted to fully recolor it, because it actually looks quite good that way. Yeah, I'll do that. So then we copy paste like that. What can we do to make him sort of interesting when he bobs? That. So then he's moving the stick up and down. Maybe if we give it a bit of a thing. Like that. A little highlight. It's already pretty short, so maybe we can do something else. But maybe that's enough. Maybe enough. We'll not push it too much. I'm on a time pressure after all. Export that. Sprites. Wizard tiles. 10 and 11. So what we'd want here is the config, and this will be the wizard who can't hit for toffee, moves about as much as you can, maybe a little bit less. Wizard, and they drop the fire card. Like that. And then we need an entity, thunder, save. Wizard.run like this, thunder. No, wizard. This isn't applicable. it'll have us spawn. Of some kind. Spawn behavior. And I suppose what we'd want to do is be like, do this, but instead, spawn behavior is a ranged behavior. Instead of var action is equal to super dot evaluate, and then if action is an attack action, then instead. Turn action. Action is equal to spawn action dot new. Because then we can keep all of this logic, which is lovely, but I don't want to have to repeat it. But then just merge it with the spawn behavior for the factory. So. Something like this. Self.pause plus something. This is self.pause entity. And our direction is equal to action.target. Minus self.pause.unit. Like that. Entity. I need to pull this out into a thing. Anyway. If well, cast is false, if cast then cast is equal to not cast. Basically, don't do anything some of the time, maybe. Well, leave that there, but not necessarily use it. Spawn action and import factory for entity factory. Import core config for config. Oh crap, my camera's turned off again, hasn't it? Why does it do that? I will be back in a moment. So make sure that this is working. Entity wizard. Spawn. Oops. That didn't work. Spawn behavior does not do cast. ID. ID, well, range and ID. Range ID plus ID. Because this should really have the ID, the range even. Range equals range. Vim Enchanted Thunder. 3. Entity. Wizard. Spawn. 10. Fireball. Let's see, behavior 124 versus that seems unlikely, but yeah, so that's probably a circular dependency bug. Because Rin gets a bit picky about the order in which things are loaded. It's fine. Factory. That's odd. Call entity 52. Target location. Vim spawn entity behavior. And target location. Propensity fireball. So technically that works. Wizard casts fireballs. Okay, so I'm going to restart the stream now just so that I can get my video back. See you in a moment.